It's 9 months after the build started, in midwinter, before Lachlan's house finally gets closed in. But now all the panels are in place, the site is a hive of activity.
Come on in, Chris.
Look at this view.
Yeah.
It feels to me like the inside-outside flow that you were after is really starting to work now, don't you think?
Oh, yeah. You know, those clever wee architects, eh?
You're pretty happy with it?
Oh, hell yeah. Big Kevin in charge. He takes on the stress of a bloody small town.
I thought he was the builder. I thought you were in charge.
Oh, no.
He wants to give me some of your stress. What's the story there?
Kevin's Dairy Shed build crew are no slackers. But surely it's been challenging for them to get up to speed with the unique demands of an architectural home.
In your average cow shed, you wouldn't have the kind of intricacies and the complexity that you might have in a high-end house like this.
You know, it's just all part of the process, you know. It's pretty rewarding at the end of it when you see some of the stuff coming together.
I'm thinking the lads have good reason to be beaming with southern pride. Until I see the back of the house.
What's going on?
There's a suspicious amount of electrical cabling near an unfinished rear door. Could this mean what I think it does?
Lachlan. Tell me, what is this? You got something to tell me?
This is a wee bit obvious, isn't it? Well, various people have told me, in fact, everybody has told me that I've got to put the other wing on. Just due to the getting the concrete aging the same, plus the actual cost of things aren't, well, nothing's going down. So we've had to make that decision, obviously, right now, for the wiring, underfloor heating, etc.
The question for me, which you said to me was really essential to this project, was that there was actually a project behind the project. And that second project was, as you call it, the wife project.
Oh, no, we haven't actually started on that one.
Lachlan is so close to completion. I can't believe he's about to start what is effectively a new build on site. It's like he's snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
Unlike most, when the foot is on the throat, you keep it on there. You don't take it off and just go, oh, it's all done, all relaxed. Keep on and get the thing finished.
Yeah, right. Lachlan's always said he's in no hurry. If anyone's putting the pressure on and feeling it, it's Kevin. Especially today. He's about to remove the supports for the cantilever.
This is what just about a year's work's come to, cutting the posts out, so hopefully I've still got a job in 10 minutes.
Yeah. Well, I think Kevin and I both got the cars warmed up a bit back, and I'll be following him out the driveway for things to start collapsing.
Things are a bit tense here. The funny thing about concrete loves compression. You know, if you put a lot of weight on top of concrete, it can resist it, no problem. But concrete is not good in tension. It will pull apart. So the only way you can really deal with it is to put a lot of steel in it. And the cantilever here is quite substantial. You can see by the massive scale of these big RSJ steel posts to hold it up while the concrete is curing. The thing is, if it isn't well designed and not well made, the whole thing could drop. In which case, Kevin's not really in a good spot.
I just hope Kevin's engineers and build team have got it right. The lad's worst fears are proof for naught, and the cantilever wing soars magnificently out over the land.
That looks beautiful.
Don't rest on your laurels, guys. There's another wing to build yet. Yeah.